If you wish to play along with the start of this video, think of any number B. I mean, don't think of a letter, think of a number. When I did this, I picked 440. Producer Nicole, when we were practicing, picked 17. Your choice, any number, we're gonna call that number B. This is optional, by the way, but more fun if you play along. So take whatever number you've got and now raise it to some power, which is gonna make it a lot bigger. You might have a much, much bigger answer on your screen. I'm a huge fan, though, of exponents. Big exponent of exponents. So whatever's on your screen now, subtract one, and that's your mystery number. And I guarantee, whatever your mystery number may be, it is divisible by one less than whatever number you started with. Yes, B, the power of n, subtract one, is always divisible by B minus one. Some people are underwhelmed by this. I was stunned. I was like, wait, why on earth is any power, subtract one, divisible by one less than the base of that power? And I was like, oh, it can't be in terms of like prime factors, because if I start with my 440, which has got a bunch of different prime factors, when I then take that and raise it to a power, in my case, I cubed it. Yes, you do keep the same factors because these are now just all cubed. But everything changes when you subtract one. Because if you subtract one off a number, you don't get to keep any of the factors because two consecutive numbers do not have any factors in common. So these are now all gone. We subtract one off down here. These are now all gone. But why on earth is the resulting number from taking one off this power a multiple of the number we started with? Why does subtracting one off a power and subtracting one off the base still mean they've got those factors? But now there are new factors down here that we didn't have before. Why on earth does that work? I thought, I have to prove this. And there are several ways you can prove it. And the reason I'm making the video is because I realized there's two different ways you can prove this fact, both of which illuminate something about doing mathematics. Because there's the kind of standard way that you would do, which is where you take some off-the-shelf pre-existing mathematics and you just hit the problem with that for long enough until you get to a solution. And that's what you actually do. If you're out doing maths as a job or in your career, you just take some math that already exists and you use it. In this case, you might start by looking at the easier case of just b squared minus one, which is the difference of two squares, which factorizes as b minus one, b plus one. And so, oh, there we are. We've now got our b minus one as a factor. In general, if you think back to polynomials, if you find the root of a polynomial, which means a value you can put into it where you get zero out the other side. In our case, b to the n minus one, if you put in one for b, you definitely get zero. So one is a root of this polynomial. It doesn't matter what n is. And if you've got any root of a polynomial, if you subtract that root off whatever the variable is, in our case, b, you definitely get a factor of that polynomial. And that proves it. That's all you gotta do. Proof done. But if you have forgotten why that is the case for the roots of polynomials, or you never knew, or you know, you just pick it up and use it as a technique, it's not giving you any insight into what's going on. Which brings me to the second proof. This is why I wanted to make the video, because by putting this in an unusual context, it suddenly becomes obvious. Something that surprised and stunned me is now patently obvious. And we're gonna switch to base B. So whenever you do this problem, you've got to think about it in the base of whatever B is. So I would have to do it in base 440. But whatever the base may be, which we're just going to call B, if you've got a power of B, then that would be written as just one and then a lot of zeros. That makes sense. And if we subtract one off that, we're going to have whatever the digit or symbol for one less than B is, which we'll just call that A. So if you subtract one off B to some power, it's now in base B, A, where A is one less than B. And if I now said, would you believe this number is divisible by A? Of course, it's all A's. It's like saying, take 10, raise that to some power, you could cube it or, you know, power of six. 10 to the six is a million. If you take a million and subtract one, it's 999999. One less than any power of 10 is all nines. If I then said, hey, would you believe that number is divisible by nine? Well, of course it is. It's all nines. It's nine times one, 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 one. And that works in any base because whatever number B you pick that's an integer You can use that as a base for a number system. And so by turning the problem into an unusual base, I don't think anyone's ever used base 440 before, but if you put it in the base of whatever B is, then suddenly it makes sense. Of course it's true. And I like that because it's a proof where I can follow the steps and at the end it's obvious. Now don't get me wrong, there might be more insight to be had, like what are the other factors? There's always more maths you can do, but I like the fact, as well as the kind of functional, just gotta do maths for my job or to do something else I wanna achieve. You've also got the fun, oh, that gives me some insight, and it was an unexpected pattern I didn't see coming. Thank you so much for watching this video. I should mention my book, Love Triangle. We are still taking pre-orders. This will be out in June in the UK and August in the US. And if you pre-order this on MathsGear at mathsgear.co.uk, you get, well, not only will I sign a first edition for you, but you get a limited edition dust jacket. We're currently handing out the tetrahedral edition of the dust jackets. And when they run out, there's plenty of the triangle one. Once they're gone, then it's over. So, oh, and it's cheaper. Cheaper on other websites like Amazon. On MathsGear, we have to charge full price because we pay all our taxes. Yeah.